Welcome to Talking Chef. I'm Adam Moore. On the show with me, I have Matt Wills, a young chef de partie from Merivale. Welcome, Matt. How are you, mate?
Very good, yourself?
You're fantastic. Now, can you tell me a little bit about yourself? Why did you become a chef?
It's always been a passion of mine. Waking up at 2 in the morning when you're 5 and going to the meat markets with my dad. It's pretty full on. Yep. Half asleep, seeing all these animals. I loved it. And that sort of started me into enjoying cooking and seeing the produce early.
You started Guillame.
Yep.
And then you went to Merivale Properties.
Yes.
How's that been?
It's all been an amazing experience. Fine dining, learning discipline from early on, and going to Merivale, learning a bit of everything. It's all helped me to get where I am today.
So when you started out, you also started in a lot of competitions. Tell me a bit about that.
My first comp was when I was in year 11 at high school.
Who brought you into competitions?
My high school teacher.
Oh, wow.
He always saw something in me. He's always stuck by my side.
Fantastic.
Still to this day, we have a beer here and there.
Now, you're working for a major competition later this year in Singapore.
So it's the Singapore Fine Food Show, and it runs over 3 days, and we're competing for one of those days. We've got like a cold buffet we set up, and we've got 12 members in the team, and we're all on a different section. We have a hot live station, we have a canapé section, we have a salad section, and a soup section.
Right. And how do you train nationally if you all got components and you're all over the state and the country?
Yep.
How do you guys train?
Every now and again we go to Perth to meet up and have team meetings. My mate Billy and I, we are relatively close. That's where we're on the same team. So he's in Wollongong. We try to meet up once or twice a month to train at the moment. That's how we do it.
Right.
And everyone else on their team are close in Perth.
With that, there's obviously a lot of mental stress. How do you prepare for a competition and how do you take on that stress?
I guess when you love what you do, I find it's a different type of stress. I don't know if there's such thing as a fun stress,
yeah.
But you love it. You do whatever you can to be the best.
Matt, if you had advice for any young chef coming in for competitions now, what would you give?
Get an amazing mentor that's going to help you day in, day out. It's going to be there for you on their days off. Weekends, everything, and they'll help you regardless of what your problem or situation is.
Now, Matt, I've known you for a long time, and one of the inspirational parts about you, you're juggling all this heavy stuff, but you've also got something personal that you're juggling with. Can you tell me a bit about that?
So I've got a lung illness, cystic fibrosis. For me, it's nothing, but for a lot of people, they think it's massive. It's after 22 years, you learn to deal with it like it's your life.
Yeah.
You just have to juggle everything around that. And I find it quite easy these days. Here and there, it's a bit more challenging, but I don't let that slow me down.
For those that don't know what you suffer, can you tell me a bit about some of the challenges you face with cystic fibrosis?
Cystic fibrosis, it's an illness where your lungs block up with mucus quite easily. My lung capacity is about 45%
Wow.
on a good day, and I think I'm at 100. I do whatever I can, and when it gets low, it's about 30.
And you say you go to hospital. Is that regular?
Maybe it's twice a year now. I'm hoping it stays that minimal, but it probably increase as it gets worse. Later on.
With cystic fibrosis, it's considered a disability because your lung is only a small part, but you don't see it as a disability, you see it as a...
It's an ability.
Ability, okay, cool, I love that. Why do you see it as an ability?
To be honest, I just see myself as everyone else. I don't like telling people, because they might look at me differently, whatnot. I like to push on as hard as everyone else and try to achieve goals that everyone else achieves.
Now, you're working in a kitchen which... would have gas fumes, there's aromas, all that sort of stuff, and dust flying around. How do you cope with that? And, you know, cystic fibrosis, you know, does decapacitate your lungs. Yeah. How do you cope with that in the kitchen?
Before in work, doing breathing exercises and medications, that always, it's a must before work and after work. Yeah. But other than that, you just have to, I don't know. When I love what I do, I don't let that bother me.
If anyone else had a disability at the moment, yeah, what would you say to them if they wanted to aspire to be a chef?
Don't let anything stop you. If you love what you do, there should be no limit to what you can do.
If you had an employer now, what would you say to them? If someone had a disability or, you know, something like cystic fibrosis, what would you say to them to help anyone with that disability?
A disability shouldn't stop you from employing someone. They could be better, if not the best chef you've worked with. A disability here and there shouldn't stop you employing them. They might need a week off here and there. It's a week. But then you're going to get 6 weeks out of them. One of the best chefs you ever worked with.
Awesome. Well, Matt, thank you. And I wish you all the very best in your competitions and your future competitions, especially the one coming in Singapore with the team. And, you know, we look forward to seeing the rest of your career throughout the next few years.
Thank you very much. It's going to be awesome.
Thank you.